Let's have a look at the satellite. You know, on the satellite, this storm is bigger than the Virginia and North Carolina states put together. So we've got a huge area here. And there is the center on satellite. It's hard to tell exactly where it is, but on radar, we pinpointed where that was. And so right now it has winds of 90 miles an hour, moving west at 6 miles an hour. And there's the pressure. So the update coming in here shortly, any minute now. And it is moving west along the coast over the next, I want to say, 12 to 24 hours. So as that happens, very slowly, it's going to deliver those strong winds to along the coast, and it's going to just cause a lot of problems from Wilmington over to coastal South Carolina. Then it moves inland, moves north, weakens, and then it may move back northeast a little bit. It'll be the remnants of it by the time it moves over this way. I think it would bring us a little extra moisture on Monday. It might bring us a little bit of extra rain. So here's Super Doppler 10. Again, there's the center. Looks like the very middle part is beginning to move on the land. So it's probably going to be on land here in the next update, but we'll see. And well, you can see all those rain bands coming in along with it. Now it is, well, there was 22 miles offshore. Now it's moved west, of course. Now here's the latest on radar for us. We've got rain bands coming into Hatteras now. It's picking up. Rodanthe also increasing. And that rain's starting to push north now, also up into Mainland Dare County. I want to say in the next 15 to 25 minutes on the south end. Now we do have some breaks over the Outer Banks at the moment, but there's more showers offshore. A break in Elizabeth City. There's been rain all over the place here, but again, it's been scattered. There's some rain south of Windsor and Bertie County, and you got some more in the southern Virginia Beach again. Again, some passing showers from time to time, but it's not widespread rain. We're not getting the widespread rain here. There's hardly anything at the moment. Eastern Shore, Middle Peninsula, and Northern Neck. And based off the latest trends, even with the model still showing some rain, I've been backing off the rain a little bit for the forecast, which is good news. But let's take a look at it. 48 inches in total for the Outer Banks. Some places maybe up to 10 in total. The winds 25 to 40 miles an hour, gust to 65. We had some very strong winds earlier. I think they are going to increase again as we go through the late morning and afternoon. Beach erosion, you got that high storm surge. Still expecting that high storm surge over the western parts of the Albemarle Sound. Rain in total, 4 to 6 inches, and winds 20 to 30, gusts up to 50 miles an hour. Now we go to the south side. Some change here. I've lowered the rain totals 2 to 3 inches possible, may even knock it down to 1 to 3. We've already had some rain in the region, and the winds gusting up to 40 miles an hour. Moderate tidal flooding, that's going to happen around the late morning and the early afternoon, and that goes again for the south side. Now here's the peninsulas. For the peninsula and the middle peninsula, both 1 to 3 inches now. I've lowered it. Winds gusting to 40 miles an hour and moderate to major tidal flooding, especially up in the river systems. So that'll be the problem there. Eastern Shore, not bad. 1, maybe 2 inches of rain. Winds gusting up to 30 and some minor tidal flooding. And that goes for the northern neck as well. All right, so we've had some strong wind gusts lately. Let's take a look at the latest with meteorologist Deitra Tate.
All right, and so we're dealing with sustained winds right now, anywhere from 15 to 25 miles per hour on average. But we do have a sustained wind right now around Hatteras, over 30 miles per hour. As far as the gusts, we're dealing with gusts over 40 for the Cape Hatteras area, and for the most part for the rest of the Outer Banks into southeastern Virginia, we're dealing with gusts primarily around 30, at times up to about 35 miles per hour. And at the highest, we're expecting to see it possibly up to 40, especially near the coast as we go through the day. But as far as the rain, we're going to continue to track the chance for scattered showers, passing showers, squally weather at times for parts of the area, especially around Elizabeth City. You'll be closer to the core of Florence before Hampton Road City specifically. We're just going to go with more of the scattered variety, better coverage expected as we head towards later this afternoon at times, and we could have some heavy downpours with that, with some really strong winds as those bands kind of slide in. Aside from that, though, again, not going to be a washout, but a day where you definitely want to be prepared for, again, the squally conditions to come on through for the south side. However, again, for northeastern North Carolina, you can expect periods of rain throughout the day, courtesy of Florence. What we will kind of watch out for, of course, is the tidal potential as we work our way towards early afternoon. I think about 1:30, 2 o'clock, even an hour before that, an hour after, we will be dealing with some moderate tidal flooding around Sewell's Point, expecting 5.5 feet. Goes down for a weekend to the minor level, and as we head on into our Sunday, more of the same, down to 4.6 feet. We are expecting major tidal flooding for places like Corralla, Fort Monroe, and Mobject Bay as we head towards early afternoon. And even for our Saturday early morning high tide times, we're looking at the moderate to major levels in those areas.